Never in my weirdest dreams I would ever think that I would have to talk about nuclear threat. Hello, I'm Dr. Sam, this is Dr. Sam's Health. I continue talking about the war in Ukraine. Unfortunately, I have to keep doing so because the war is still going on. And at this point, I still don't feel like working on anything else in terms of making videos about health, fitness, nutrition. And today I have a very special subject, which is a nuclear threat coming from Russia. This is something unthinkable, something that I never thought I would be talking about in my YouTube channel. And definitely, I hope that nothing like that will ever happen. But right now, we are at the point where Russia is effectively directly or indirectly threatening the world with the use of nuclear weapons, or just pretty much throwing in some nuclear threats. We have lived for 70 years, actually for 70 years after Hiroshima and Nagasaki bombing, and we had quite a few anthropogenic, technogenic catastrophes such as Chernobyl or Fukushima, but I don't think we have ever been at the brink of nuclear war. This is the most ridiculous thing I could ever think about. And until recently, I actually didn't think that anything like that would be even possible. But on the other hand, I never thought that Russia fully invading Ukraine with their army is also a possible thing. Until the day one, I never thought that something like this could occur again in the middle of Europe. Two sister or brother nations are fighting with each other, or I would rather say Russians attacking Ukraine, and this is terrible times. Before I go on, a couple of my standard waivers or disclaimers. I'm a medical doctor. I'm not gonna give any kind of medical advice. I'm not gonna talk about anybody's diagnosis as much as I'm tempted to, or people asking me about, say, pudding or things like that, or people like that. I actually made a video about him where I spoke about his qualities as a leader. Let's put it this way. And also, I'm expressing just my opinions, my musings, my thoughts, and they do not necessarily represent the opinions of my governing bodies, my colleges, my universities, my profession, and my colleagues, or pretty much anybody else. They're just solo than mine, and I take full responsibility for them. So, as I said a while ago, I could never think that something like an actual nuclear strike could happen. But after seeing all the atrocities that Russia has committed in Ukraine, I'm starting to think that these people have no morals. Half of them don't have fully functioning brain, apparently, because of the stupid things that they're doing, the miscalculations. And I can see a lot of vile things, vile rhetoric coming out of this part of the world in general. There was this catastrophe or a disaster with the Nord Stream, the gas pipeline. Actually, I think both of them are affected. You can think about anything right now. I've seen the bodies of people who were raped and tortured in Bucha and Irpin. I've seen rockets flying and hitting absolutely like civilian objects, mall centers, civilian buildings, multiplexes in my city. They still keep shelling my city, whereas there is no chance that they're gonna attack it. And I also made a video about state terrorism, because I believe that what they're doing right now is a act of terror, or a terrorist act, a series of those terrorist politics. And I am afraid that if it was completely up to them, they would have already used nuclear weapons. So I still believe that the use of nuclear weapons, or nuclear threats, nuclear threats are happening, but I hope it will not happen. I mean, the actual nuclear hits in one way or another, but I still see how they are actually possible. So I would say they are unlikely, but quite possible. And I can see three possibilities, or three scenarios when Russians would use their nuclear powers. Number one is I don't think I would call it conventional, but like a standard strategic nuclear strike, something that uses ballistic missiles or strategic aviation. They have it. I think it's the least likely scenario for a variety of reasons. First of them would be the fact that these ballistic missiles are quite visible and they are carrying huge loads. The nuclear warheads on them, they can cause like tremendous level of destruction. And I do not think that this is even compatible with any kind of further war related actions, peace talks, anything like that. But that's not the main reason. I don't think that these people, the people who are running Russia right now, have any morals or ethics or anything humane left. I think that the main deterrent from that is actually the whole system of anti-nuclear weapons that has been built by multiple countries in the world. Things like missiles, like strategic ballistic missiles, they are noticeable. Everybody in the world, I guess, all these agencies, they are monitoring nuclear weapons. They are aware of all nuclear warheads, where they are located in the world. And if one of them flies, likely there will be either fully automated or partially automated response from multiple other nuclear countries, United States, NATO countries, maybe China, India, you name it. There will be other ballistic rockets that will fly towards Russia. So that, in my opinion, is the main deterrent from this happening. And Russia doing something like that would automatically mean the beginning of full-blown World War III and pretty much the end of the world. So I don't think that that is possible. But at the same time, there is a very small possibility then that they might use one of these ballistic rockets, missiles, but they will not use them from Russian territory. Some people were talking about potential of using these rockets and like launching them from Belarus. And ironically, I'm starting to think that it's quite possible because I think that they will confuse the automated systems responding to nuclear launches if they do that, because I don't think that Belarus is a nuclear state. And if they launch something from their territory, there will be a very short trajectory of this kind of ballistic missile. And when it hits something on Ukrainian territory, it will the difference, time difference between the launch and the hit would be literally several minutes. And there is a chance that all the world defenses will be defenseless against that. They will not respond timely. I hope I'm not giving anybody any ideas. And I don't think that anybody from Russian government are watching me, so I think we're good here. Another option is Russians using this the one of their strategic bombers. They actually can launch certain nuclear warheads, and they can do it from pretty much anywhere in the world, but they can do it from some location that is far enough from Russia. Well, I'm starting to create like all kinds of scenarios. I'm not an expert in that. My point is that it is very unlikely that Russia would use this kind of nuclear weapons. The second scenario is slightly more likely. It is something that is related to tactical nuclear weapons. So, as you likely know, Russia and many other countries, they have tactical nukes, which is just way smaller nuclear charges that are being delivered using not ballistic rockets, but way smaller delivery mechanisms, which likely will not be kind of that alarming for all the nuclear supervision systems or monitoring systems of the world. Something that can fly in low altitude, something that can, I don't know, cover 1,000 kilometers, and that would be enough. And they obviously carry way smaller nuclear charges that will not be enough to destroy a big city, but they will be enough to destroy a city quarter, or a set of buildings, or a military base, or cover a relatively large area with the nuclear strike. Again, I believe that they might use something like that, just because all these nuclear deterrent systems will not respond likely to this kind of nuclear strike. Several questions that I have is like, what would they attack? The most logical area or object would be some sort of a military object, but to my knowledge, Ukrainian military forces are kind of scattered all over the place, and they are actively fighting with Russians. They're actively relocating, so I don't even think there is any point in like hitting any kind of nuclear base, or sorry, nuclear like military base. So I wonder what would be the target. Another target would be some cities like Kyiv, because they were talking about the hitting the centers of decision making, and that might be like literally hitting the center of Ukraine, center of Kyiv, and like destroying the government with one hit. I think that this obviously is possible, but that would be even worse than all kinds of stuff that they have done before. It will go beyond terrorism. I think that if they hit a city with a nuclear strike, that's beyond inhumane. I do not even know how to call it. The problem with that is that we have precedents where the course of wars were changed, specifically one war, World War II, with nuclear strikes. We're talking about Hiroshima and Nagasaki, and somehow Russians, at least those that I have been talking to, they always try to compare actions of Russia with actions of the United States and NATO. Say that you bombed Iraq, you attacked Syria, you attacked Afghanistan. Why can't we attack Ukraine? It doesn't make any sense for a civilized person, but that's the way they think. And I'm afraid that if they do something like that, and if there is no counteraction from the rest of the world in terms of like other countries launching nuclear missiles or strikes at Russia, they will always be able to say that, well, you did it to Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Now we are doing this because Ukrainians are, I don't know, again, Nazis, it's a fascist state, and we are afraid of Russia's integrity, and we're afraid that Ukrainians, whom you have been supplying with weapons and offensive weapons, they're gonna invade Russia. It doesn't make any sense, but that is the rhetoric they have been using throughout this conflict and before that. They always come up with something absolutely absurd. Still, they will be able to use this kind of arguments when they're talking about this potential incident. And the best deterrent against that would be a very stern position of all world leaders, unified, stern, promising very serious consequences for acts like that. And unfortunately, in the last 10, 20, 30 years, Russia has been doing whatever they wanted, and the world did not respond properly. These were very weak responses. Just, they invade Crimea, annex Crimea, so, oh, bad Russians, we're going to use some sanctions against you. But they still keep buying their gas, they still keep inviting them to all kinds of international events. Russia is still part of EU, still part of multiple international organizations, and they have a veto power. So I'm afraid that Russians might think that they can pull the thing like that. Again, I hope that in the last several weeks, the rhetoric of other countries has changed significantly, and there were actual direct threats to Russia from other countries, meaning that they actually warn in Russia that if something like that will happen or happens, there will be immediate and very stern response. I'm not sure that Russians listen. At this point, I'm starting to think that their government understand only the arguments of power. And the previous behaviors of the same governments, say the France, the government of France, the government of Germany, Hungary, many other places, they were not as stern as I think would be appropriate in this kind of situation. Nevertheless, I still, actually, as I talk about this, I'm starting to think that it's quite a likely scenario. That quite likely scenario, I mean, like there is like 2-3% chance that something like that would happen. And unfortunately, what Russians are doing right now, they are trying to organize this referenda that will allow them to annex more Ukrainian territories. And then some of their propagandists are talking about the fact that in Russian nuclear doctrine, it says that if their territory or their integrity is under attack, they might use nuclear weapons. So I think that that's the unique constellation of things that increases tensions tremendously. And I still hope that obviously that will not happen. So there is also the third variant, third scenario for Russians to use nuclear weapons. And sorry, I said weapons, but I mean nuclear powers. Unfortunately, Russians have put the world in danger by pretty much their mere presence on the grounds of one or two nuclear power plants in Ukraine. The most famous at this point is the Zaporizhia nuclear power plant. And as you know, there were lots of tensions because of them being there, and they are accusing Ukrainians in trying to hit the nuclear plant and blow it up effectively. And at the same time, I'm pretty sure that these people can do something terrible, meaning that they might cause some sort of an accident there that will lead to an explosion and second Chernobyl effectively, or second Fukushima, again in the middle of Europe. And Ukraine, unfortunately, has a history of nuclear disasters. And given the presence of Russians and their lack of, not their, I mean, like their president's lack of morals and any kind of ethics, something like this can happen. And they will always blame Ukrainians, saying, oh, there was Ukrainians. And while the whole world will, you know, not buy their lies, everybody will be too busy with cleaning up the mess that they created. And they have just created the mess with this gas pipeline. We don't know if it was man-made disaster, but just like conveniently happened specifically at this point. There might have been other countries involved, I don't know. But the fact is that one of the gas lines or both of them are affected, and that is a clear signal. Like it's conveniently looks like a clear signal from Kremlin that, you know, if the world doesn't talk to them, they're gonna do something. They're gonna throw tantrums, and these tantrums will look very bad for environment and for pretty much everything else. So I'm afraid that this third scenario is the most likely one out of the three I described. Also, I actually just recall something. There were some talks about Russians trying to hit Snake Island because it has some symbolic meaning, and they can just like show, it will be like a show of nuclear power. They can use tactical nuclear strike to hit the island, destroy whoever is on this island, and just to show the world that we can do it. And in their perverted logic, it will mean that they have their say, or they will They are working towards having some sort of negotiations. Nevertheless, I think that there are three scenarios again, and I think they are quite, the likelihood of any of them happening is quite low, but unfortunately, I see that these people can do anything, and there is a possibility of one of these disasters happening. So that was pretty much everything I want to talk about. Sorry, it turned out to be a little bit longer video than I expected. And I'm gonna wrap up. Actually, I'm exhausted today. I just wanted to make this video because I've got a series of very busy clinical days and lots of other commitments. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, try to spread this video through via your social networks. I want the world to be aware of what Ukrainians abroad think about this situation. I'm getting information from different sources, including some of them are Canadian, Western sources, Ukrainian sources, unfortunately Russian sources. And I have been thinking about all of these things and just trying to present you with some analytical conclusions. Again and again and again, I hope nothing like that will ever happen to the world. We don't need this. It will be a total disaster. But we always have to prepare for the worst. And I think that the world leaders have to think hard about the role of Russia in the society, in the fabric of our civilization effectively. Once again, thank you for watching. I'll see you in my next video. Check out my website, Dr. Sam's Health. I have not been working on health too much there, but the site is still there, and you can check my videos there. And throw in some ideas, leave comments, message me. I'm always happy to communicate with my subscribers and in general with people. Once again, thank you for watching. Slava Ukraini!